Yo, what is going on everyone? It's TK and welcome back to the channel. On today's video, as you saw from the thumbnail and the title, we're going to upgrade our Town Hall to 16, but the update is coming in a few hours probably by the time I'm dropping this video. So this will be an upgrade guide basically for it. So what is upgrade guide? It's basically a path and a base link that I made for you on what I think will be the most valuable to you to upgrade. And let's just start by going in and upgrading our Town Hall to level 16 when the update drops, of course, and the rest I'll show you in a second. All right, first thing you need to do after you upgrade to Town Hall 16 is to purchase the blacksmith from the shop. And of course, we don't have it now, but you need to purchase that ASAP. And if you got a lot of books, or if you don't have a lot of books but have, you know, just one or two books maybe from gold passes, and you're just maybe a lot more free to play player, try to upgrade it as far as you can, because it's definitely going to help your heroes to do a lot, especially level 2 or 3 when it's just giving a lot more value to your queen with the giant arrow. Now, the only thing about this video that could be different is the way you're going to merge your troops. That is completely up to you. I'm not gonna tell you what to do. I'm just gonna tell you what I will do. And then if you wanna continue to do something like me, or something like maybe you're gonna wait for your pro players, your favorite player, to see if what they're doing, or maybe your favorite content creator, that's up to you. But personally, I'm going to merge for now one cannon and one archer tower, nothing more. So I'm gonna have one of each still in the store, because you can get two of them. I might do two archer towers by the time that, you know, I'm uploading this video. I might change my mind, but that is it for me personally. And that is for the new things that are coming to the store, and you know, when you go to the Town Hall 16. The next up thing that you need to upgrade is the pet house. These two, the pet house and the blacksmith, are the first two buildings you need to put your hands on the upgrades. And then if you have one book left, if you have a, you know, hammer, go with a laboratory, because do not forget, you still have hammers from before, and you can still buy hammers currently when the update drops if you had the 1 week cooldown finished, you know. But a lot of players have more than just one book, so you know, I'm just giving you ideas of if you're a free to play player, or if you're like me and you spend money in the game and you have more books than the other players. Second thing is the new troop. And by the way, once you get this laboratory done, I believe with the boost of Town Hall, you're gonna have all the new like levels, so you don't actually need to upgrade anything in the laboratory itself, or you can just use the boost of the laboratory to get like the boost of the troop, sorry, to get all your troop level to the maximum of your current laboratory level. Simple as that. So do that. Do not upgrade any troop yet, because you're just gonna waste elixir when you can upgrade your Grand Warden, or upgrade some few other things like storages. But don't worry, we're gonna get there. Now, the first defense and the first thing I'm gonna tell you to upgrade is the bomb towers. Because of the blizzard and because of the super archer, you know, blimps, you need to have this defense upgraded so you can still defend it and gives the attacker that little scary feeling when they're attacking your base. Moving on, we got two rows here. That is up to you. If you got the books, if you got the juice, if you got the runes, go for it and upgrade the expos. If you don't have it, if you're a free to play player, upgrade the storages first, because then once you get one or two runes, they are gonna be the most valuable to you. A lot of people out there are just buying runes randomly. Well, not to saying myself here. You can go to my magic items. I have like 3 runes of gold here. Not too much, but still, it's more than one. So I don't really care about getting that extra, you know, 2 million out of my gold, because I already have 132 million. So I'm not going to upgrade this stuff first, but I'm going to the right row. So I'm going into the expos, trying to upgrade them. And then this is where one thing I'm gonna tell you, if you want to upgrade your giant bombs and bombs after the bomb towers, go for it. That is not what I would do, because I have I don't know how much I have on this account. Okay, 40 potions, and you know, a few of them, once you use it, the giant bomb level, it's I think 10 days if I'm not mistaken. It could be less or more, but in a few hours you can get that done with the potions, so you don't have to invest the builders on them. I just need to get a few buildings done, so I have 6 builders again, and I think I might use even the 7th builder, and that is one thing that could be very useful, having 7 giant bombs upgrading at the same time with the hero and builder potion, and you can absolutely demolish hogs, super archers, super wizards with this giant bombs and the bomb tower level. So that is what I would tell you to do up until now. Hopefully you got the idea of where I'm going with this guide and how to, you know, if you're free to play or if you're paid to, you know, play the game. And in general, that is the main thing about this. Next up, we got these 3 sets of defenses, then the heroes. Of course, the air defenses are more valuable than wizard towers and mortars, so go for the upgrade there. There's going to be a lot of spam air attacks, so get those air defenses done and dusted. And by the way, you can leave these. You can leave them. They are going to get nerfed, so when you upgrade them, they're basically the same level as a Town Hall 15 bomb, so it's not like the biggest deal. Plus, no one is really like that much of a Lalo player, maybe a queen charge, but you still kill the queen healer with all these bombs anyway. So if you want to put it in front of your town hall or behind the town hall, go for it. Do not upgrade it yet. You can upgrade it the last, doesn't really matter that much. Moving on to the wizard tower and the mortar, that depends on you. Me personally, I like the wizard tower design, so I'm going to upgrade the wizard tower myself and then the mortar. But guess what? I have the heroes at the back. This doesn't mean you need to upgrade them late, and it doesn't mean you need to upgrade them early, because you can still invest that hero potion on your heroes and the pets, don't forget, because once you unlock the fox, the spirit fox in here, you can get it to level 5. Invest your dark elixir on the fox first, guys, not your heroes, because if you have books, once you get that fox to level 5 with the books and, you know, the runes and the help of dark elixir, even gems, anything you got, get it to level 5, and then once you use the, you know, potion of heroes, you're gonna have a maxed pet with 4 maxed heroes. So there is no point of just going for one hero upgrade, then you have a spirit fox level 1. It's really not worth it. Plus, you are not going to be using it in battle for a long time because you're just upgrading it. So that is my suggestion. Keep the heroes for the end. I think I have maybe 6 or 7 Book of Heroes. Yeah, I got 6 here. I got a few Book of Everything too on this account, but on the other account I will max everything with the, you know, heroes, the pets and all this stuff. So that is no problem on the other account, but this one I wanted to make the video on this account specifically so I can give you the idea of what I would do if I didn't have enough runes, or if I had average runes, or even a bit above average runes, because the other account, it's just insane. It's just too much. I've been buying offers for a long time, so that is just out of this world. But anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this guide, learned a few things about what is the most valuable thing in this update if you didn't know about a few things, like a small little bomb tower giant bomb trick, or the potion trick with those 7 giant bombs and the little goblin that can help you finally in this update. But yeah, I'm gonna have the link of this base down below in the description, so make sure you copy it once the update drops so you can upgrade everything in a nice order without any distraction to your attacks. But definitely think about those merged troops, you cannot go back. So what I recommend, as well as I'm doing, one with each for now. I might do 2 archer tower just because we have more archer towers, and at the same time they are a bit more damage, plus they hit air, and once they're doing 3 damage separately, if there is 1 troop in front of them, they do more damage to the troop with those 3 archer hits. But a cannon doesn't do that. The cannon is a lot weaker in my opinion, and it just has a lot of HP. It's like a mini eagle, you know, but it doesn't matter that much. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Hopefully I will see you soon, very soon, with the Max Town Hall 16 content. So make sure you stay tuned, subscribe to the channel, and like this video. Comment down below what you will be upgrading first, so I'm going to read all those comments and answer all of your questions. Take care and peace.